when the presses suddenly got stopped on treasured titles like New Zealand Women's Weekly and The Listener, we were all shocked.
So the news that a buyer's stepping up is super promising for those of you who are paying subscriptions for magazines that never showed up.
That's true. Now, Bauer Media is asking readers to stick with them as the sale gets finalised. But what if you'd rather get your money and run? Well, fortunately, Garth's here to help.
They're playing the fair go, no refund blues.
Bauer Media needs to get in touch with me and say, we're refunding you your money.
They're zooming in from Invercargill with some crosswords.
I got the impression that Bauer Media used COVID-19 as an excuse to shut down in New Zealand.
It's still got their money. Subscriptions up to $160 each.
The whole thing seems to have been mishandled as far as I'm concerned.
Remember, German Goliath Bauer Media yelled stop the presses a week into lockdown. It blamed COVID, a tough market, and the government. The government put it back on Bauer. Bauer put the mags on the market and put the subscribers on hold.
It riles me that Bauer Media haven't contacted me.
Neville is vexed. He paid for a year's worth of listeners, just the latest in 60 years of support. It feels very one way.
It's been dead silence.
Paul's out in his garage tuning his car and quietly fuming for his lost listeners.
They hadn't been declared bankrupt or anything, so they simply chose to stop delivering a service that we'd paid for. It's just not right.
Paul says it's not just about the money.
I just don't think that's acceptable for any company, you know, especially a foreign company that owns iconic New Zealand things.
Is that better?
Jocelyn must be New Zealand Women's Weekly fangirl number one.
I've been buying the Women's Weekly either for my mother or myself since I was eight. 1955, to be precise.
The Queen would have been a cover story then, too.
Oh, I just miss the whole thing. It's something from New Zealand. I love the puzzles. I love doing those. There's not much of it that I don't read.
If Jocelyn can master Zoom during lockdown, is it too much to ask a big corporate to handle a refund? Bauer terms are pretty clear on the Magshop website, which Bauer owns. If one of their publications ceases, they can offer you an alternative subscription, or you can choose to have a refund. You just have to ask.
How hard could that be? Well, no one here at Bauer was picking up the phone, so we emailed the head office in Hamburg in German. It wasn't great German, mine's quite rusty. Keine Antwort, no reply. Then suddenly, by striking coincidence, within hours of Fairgo making contact with some of the people involved with the sale of these classic magazine titles, a buyer became public. Hooray! Or is it?
It's not clear whether a deal to buy the Bauer Media Group will save some iconic Kiwi magazines.
Bauer didn't want to front. Instead, we got this. Anyone who wants a refund can have one. In fact, they've been giving them since April. Subscriptions will resume shortly. Subscribers will receive the full number of magazines they've paid for.
They will have to have an assurance that they were going to start up within the next month. Otherwise, I would be asking for my refund.
Might be at least 2 months, Jocelyn, and no guarantees for listener fans.
If it was the same, then I'd happily then buy another subscription. But I think that's my choice, not theirs.
I think I'd buy a couple at the newsstands, you know, just to start off, unless they send me one free, you know, for me to have a look at.
Fairgo has passed their details to someone handling Bauer's interests who has promised to respond. They might get a bit of a rev too.
That is a fine automobile.
It sure is.
Now,
yes.
If you're a subscriber to any of these much-loved magazines and you do want a refund, you need to email magshop@magshop.co.nz. We're going to put that address on our Facebook page, so don't panic.